You are the us. Even if he never does anything else for us, he's been awesome for bringing us this far, for doing the things that he's done for us, hallelujah, because he didn't have to do it, because we didn't deserve it, but he still saw that he gave us what we needed to supply the earth.
Keep me in the valley. with us in your heart. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is one true church, apostolic and universal, whose holy faith let us now declare. I'm gonna be
feel welcome. Enjoy yourself. If we miss anyone, please, please, don't charge it to our hearts, only to our minds, because we forget. But there are just a few that we would like to thank for coming so far, so far, so far.
Guaranteed to bring 104. The best day.
I couldn't find an orange in there. So tonight, when you give your money, which is your seed, expect nothing but money back. The best benefit package going. There's no better one. When you give tonight, you're investing in yourself. Who wants to be a millionaire in here?
Thank you.
God tonight. Amen. Amen. I have the wonderful privilege of introducing our presiding bishop. Amen. Bishop Marcia, who is the wife of Bishop Edward Jones. Bishop Pitts has 3 daughters and 1 son. She has 5 grandchildren. She's been pastoring for quite a while now. Amen. God called her, I believe, from her mother's womb and have ordained her for such a time as this. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. To know Bishop Pitts is to love her today.
Yeah.
You'll find that Bishop Pitts is a kind, considerate, loving, gentle woman of God. She's a woman that has a heart after God's own heart. She loves the saints. She loves the church of God. She's a praying woman. She's a student of the word of God. Amen. And she loves to praise God in the service. Somebody say amen. So we're glad tonight that we're under such a powerful bishop and pastor such as Bishop Marcia. Amen. And I love her so deeply because she has helped me so much in my spiritual life. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I thank God that I'm not where I used to be. And it's all because of her. Because of her teaching and preaching the truth of the living God. Somebody say amen. A lot of pastors are wishy-washy. Some are not living all that they should be living. But I can attest today, and I can testify that this woman of God is living just what she's preaching. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. I thank God for her. In all the days of her life, she has said yes to the Lord. Amen. And God has honored her. Yes, she is highly anointed. Oh, yes, she is. Just a couple of weeks ago in the church, I was having trouble with my arm. The muscle I could hardly lift it. And I asked her for prayer after she had prayed for the people and after she had preached. And I know she was tired, but I also know she had the anointing. So I said, Bishop, I need you to pray for me. And so she began to pray. I wasn't even listening to what she was praying. I just began to praise God and thank God. Praise God. So after the prayer, I just lifted up my arm and I noticed that I was healed. And I said, Bishop, I'm healed. So I know the woman is of God, and I thank God that I'm under such a woman as her. Amen?
Amen.
So after the Salamic selection of the Convocation Choir, the next voice you will hear will be this anointed woman of God, this bishop that God has consecrated, amen, in her mother's womb, and sent her forth to do what he has sent her forth to do. Amen? After the singing of the choir will be the preaching of the word from none other than our pastor and presiding bishop, Bishop Marcia. Amen.